saw Pete DeBoer, he was joking this morning, he and his new assistant coach, Steve Spott, they got lost on the way to T-Mobile in the only game they've had here since joining the team. Nine of the next 10 are here, starting tonight. Underway at T-Mobile, Alex Petrangelo with a wrist shot and a blocker save by Malcolm Subban. And now a drive, score! Zach Sanford ripped it home. Stick side on Subban, it doesn't tip, the blow's long. 25 seconds.
Off to the right of Subban, the shot goes wide, a save by Subban. And then a good play by O'Reilly, he finds Sanford and he gets all of that, he wires it.
And the Golden Knights on the power play, brought to you by Adam Kuttner. Here's Mark Stone looking, he'll feed it towards the net, block, second chance, score! Max Pacioretty buries it! 8 seconds into the power play to tie the game in one.
Possession, a good job on the draws. It's won right back by Stastny to Theodore. A little roll and Stone. He just gets us the net for a shot tip. It goes off the skate right to Pacioretty. I believe it goes off a Blues player. Parayko right to Pacioretty. Makes no mistake. Quick release. 25 all the year.
And they felt in the frustration of that kind of filtered through the rest of their game. They took some penalties, gave up a season high 3 power play goals. His touch wrist shot is turned away by Binnington. When William Karlsson fires it in. Puck loose into the middle for Ryan O'Reilly. Stone intercepts. Off to Karlsson. Wrist shot. Zach Binnington. Rebound score! That's Pacioretty. Put in his own rebound. 2 goals tonight and 26 on the season.
Said one of the keys tonight. Win the battles in front of the net. Well, watch Pacioretty's battle. Once, twice. Fights off Parayko to get the second chance. And that is a perfect example of winning a battle for a big goal, as second of the night as the Golden Knights grab the 2-1 lead.
They won the first 4 games of that homestand, lost the next 3, then lost in Buffalo, and then the coaching change. Perron will feed it out high, wrist shot from Bortuzzo, save Subban, rebound, score! Zach Sanford has 2 for St. Louis. Numbers 9 and 10, and he's tied the game at 2.
As the Blues just off the forecheck, good battle by O'Reilly, support from Perron, finds Bortuzzo, he gets it to Sanford in front, and Sanford to the backhand, his second of the game, up to 10 on the year to tie this game at 2. Not even halfway through the first, and we have 4 goals and just 2 goal scorers.
Yeah, Pacioretty with both for the Golden Knights. Way by Nosek. He'll shovel it out. Second career 2-goal game. Here's Reeves walking in. Robbed by Binnington. Nosek on the rebound blocked.
Chances. Gets a chance on a little quick 2-on-1. Nosek on the follow-up. And Binnington with a big save with a glove.
Now Reeves plays it up the wall. Battle for it. Holden able to poke it away from Barbashev. Kyrou. Ford Dunn looking down low, tip score! Ivan Barbashev on the redirect. Nice look by Dunn, the high tip by Barbashev to give the Blues a 3-2 lead.
I mean, it's the high slot. Watch the play in the corner. Everybody gets caught watching there. Barbashev goes right between the hash marks. He's all alone, and a great play by the defenseman. A little shot pass, and that is a perfect deflection with a good screen in front by McEachran. And just like that, the Blues on top, 3-2.
In the game against the Golden Knights in the Gateway City back in December. Second period underway. And Riley Smith lost it. Steen, a rush shot, save Subban. And he stopped the rebound, too. Back-to-back saves by Malcolm Subban. Well, Braden Schenner just recently ended a 14-game goalless drought. What a chance. Now Sanford, a rush shot, save Subban. And the rush shot for Petrangelo and Subban there again. Sanford for the hat trick scores. That'll count. And it's the first career hat trick for Zach Sanford. And a 4-2 Blues lead.
And then after that, another turnover by the Golden Knights leads to a couple of chances. Big save off Petrangelo. Petrangelo follows up and finds Sanford in front for his 3rd of the night. 4-2 St. Louis. Reeves had a big goal against the Blues last time in this building that helped start the comeback in the 3rd.
Here's Holden off the draw. He'll shovel it down and Will Carrier shake it up. Stone takes a peek at the clock. directing traffic, wants to get that stick out of the way, and he does. Theodore clears it. Here is Stone. Out high to Marchessault. Shot! Score! Jonathan Marchessault, the power play with 61 seconds to go in the period. The Golden Knights within one.
And that allows Marchessault to pop up high, and that goes off of Steen in the high slot and into the corner on the glove side.
In the corner it goes. Stastny trying to dig it up. Loose puck, Marchessault. Not a Stone shot. Save Bennington. And the rebound cleared. Carlson trying to hit a streaking tuck. Tuck in first. Cuts behind the net. Feeds it to Carlson. Now Schmidt a one. Timer score! Mike Schmidt with a bomb! A power play goal to tie the game at four.
Tuck's going to get first on it. Comes all the way around. He finds Carlson. Shot, great screen by Riley Smith. Watch Riley Smith, right to the front of the net. He's in Bennington's eyes, and Nate Schmidt with a perfectly placed one-timer beats Bennington over the right shoulder to tie this game at four as Schmidt has his seventh on the year.
Power play over for St. Louis. Tuck out of the box. Dunn, wrist shot, tip wide of the net. Parayko in behind the case, center, it's gone! Tipped in down low. Sanford was in front just as the power play had expired for St. Louis.
An exhausted penalty kill group on the ice. Vegas had some chances earlier to clear. They couldn't. And good play behind the net as Parayko finds Sanford. Gets a little separation from Englund. Stick on the ice. And Sanford with his fourth of the game.
Blues with a one-point lead on Colorado for the number one spot in the West. Stevenson with a steal, blunts it down, looking towards the net, centered it, and tucked it, a stick tied up by Blaine. Now wrist shot from Merrill, tip score! Alex Tuck on the deflection with 4:40 left to tie the game again.
He's the last man. Good play by Stevenson, who took the turnover, kept it alive. John Merrill gets it to the net. You can see Stevenson out high and then Tuck right in front. Stevenson looks to touch this puck first and then Tuck in front deflects it back.
He'll play it up the wall. O'Reilly's going to skate it out. And overtime at T-Mobile. Marchessault back the other way with Carlson and Schmidt on the move. Carlson into the offensive zone. There's Marchessault. Tuck, save! Bennington. Good chance for Marchessault to win it. And hustling, Stone kept it in right on the line. Lays it off for Marchessault. Cross to Pacioretty. Trying to center it. Gunnarsson blocked it. Pacioretty says, rebound score! Jonathan Marchessault on a power play for a 6-5 overtime win.
So the great play, Stone, to keep that puck in. The hustle. Then a little through the seam, gets Brock Pacioretty, shot, rebound, right to Marchessault, off to the side of the net, no chance for Bennington. But great hustle, and Jonathan Marchessault wins it. Another exciting game between these two teams and the power play. With a huge overtime goal by number 81 to win it 6-5 for Vegas.